Okay, so we are talking about these components of the airplane: the primary control surfaces, ailerons, elevator, and rudder. And secondary control surfaces, here in this image you can see that it is the flaps, right? So when it is coming to the airplane, it comes to the aeroplane, so that is heavier than air category we have. And as the fuselage is concerned, that's the central body which accommodates passengers, pilot, and wing attachments, tail attachments are all available in this fuselage, right? And as far as the propeller is concerned, which is a rotating device, and it is used to produce the thrust for an aircraft by rotating that blades. Okay, and what about, we have two types of stabilizer. One is a horizontal stabilizer, another one is a vertical stabilizer. The horizontal stabilizer is used for horizontally stabilize that aircraft, and vertical stabilizer is used to stabilize that aircraft vertically, right? And as far as the control surfaces are considered, so we have two categories of the control surfaces. One, it is primary control surface, and second one, it is secondary control surfaces. And as far as the primary control surfaces are concerned, there are three primary control surfaces which are fixed, not more than three. So those three primary control surfaces are ailerons, elevators, and rudders. Ailerons, elevators, and the rudders. And here in this image, we can see the ailerons, elevators, and rudder movements. So by making the ailerons movement, we are getting the rolling motion when the ailerons are moved in an opposite direction. When the ailerons movement is made in the opposite direction, we are getting the rolling movement on the aircraft. When the rudder is moved in the right hand side, the aircraft nose is also moving onto the right hand side. So that means the directional change is possible within a rudder surface. So that is, we are getting a yawing movement with the rudder. And as far as the elevator is concerned, the aircraft will be going like this: pitch up, pitch down, pitch up, pitch down. Right, the aircraft, straight level aircraft, then pitch up, pitch down. Right, so this is made by the elevator. This is made from the elevator. And as far as the rudder is concerned, the nose of the aircraft will be changing. So left, right, this is being changed from the nose of the aircraft. And as far as the ailerons are concerned, two ailerons are there on the aircraft. So one elevator, if it is move up, other elevator is being moved down. And wherever the aileron is being moved up, so that side the aircraft will be lifting high. And this way that starts rolling. This way the aircraft will start rolling. And if this aileron lifts up and this aileron goes down, so the aircraft will be rolling like this. Right. So this is what are three movements achieved from three control surfaces. And in addition to this, we have even known about this axis. We should know even about the axis. The nose to the tail running axis is known as the longitudinal axis. And wing tip to the tip is known as the lateral axis. And vertically, when you are measuring that one, so that it is known as a vertical axis. That it is in a vertical axis. So we'll discuss in the later sessions about the stability points of this particular aircraft. Right. So as of now, we will only deal with the control surface and the movement achieved on it, and about the axis of rotation. Now, as far as wing is concerned, or the aileron rolling moment is concerned, it is about its central. So that is about the longitudinal axis. The rolling moment is achieved about the longitudinal axis. The rolling moment is achieved. So that is nose of the aircraft to the tail of the aircraft. This axis is fixed, about which this is making the rotations. That is the longitudinal axis. And as far as the lateral is concerned, so in the lateral side, have to keep this lateral axis fixed. So where the aircraft can move is it can pitch up and pitch down like this. It can pitch up and pitch down. So when your lateral axis is fixed, right? Now another one, when your directional axis is fixed, so that means the aircraft has to go right and left. So that is in the axis of directional or vertical axis. Three axis, three movements. Axis of rotation. Okay. So that is about. Now here in this image, we can see when the right aileron is lifted up, so the aircraft would be rising the right wing up and the left wing down. So the aircraft is going in the anti-clockwise direction. Right. So when the left aileron is lifted up, the aircraft will be going in the clockwise direction. So when I'm viewing it from the tailward direction, this I'm talking about. And as far as the aileron is concerned, simple way and the standard way to remember is, so when the aileron is moved up, the nose of the aircraft also will move up. Right? How that and all, we'll discuss the physics in detail. Right? How, when the, a simple way to remember for is, that when the aileron is up, the nose of the aircraft is also up. So that is because of the moment created on that aircraft from the CG location. So as this elevator is from the distance from this particular CG location. So as the elevator is certain distance from the CG location, so this is creating a net moment on that particular tail wing location. So that net moment resulting is giving the upward and the downward. So when the elevator is move upward, the aircraft nose is going in the upward direction. Okay. So in the aileron, so here the elevator is moved up, so the aircraft nose is also moving in the upward direction. So when the elevator is in the downward direction, the aircraft nose also will turn towards the downward direction. Now, why this upward and downward direction of the elevator movement is required? Because when you are making the elevator movement, only the aircraft can pitch up and pitch down. So this movement is achieved when you are making that elevator movement only. So for the aircraft to make the pitch up and pitch down motion or movement, we need that elevator surface, which is a movable surface. Now, as far as the rudder is concerned, now here in this rudder, so if your rudder is moving towards the left hand side, the nose of the aircraft is also turning towards the left hand side. Simple way to remember the physics, I'll explain you in the sessions or in the later sessions. Okay, so simple way to remember is whichever the direction rudder is moving, in the same direction nose of the aircraft is also moving here. So that is why taking the advantage or from the rudder, we are getting the yawing moment of the aircraft where it is happening about the vertical axis. So here also about the CG, the force is acting on it and resultant force is giving in the opposite direction. So that is here we can see in the arrows represented. That's an aerodynamic force to which the nose of the aircraft is acting in the opposite direction, because this aerodynamic force is acting behind CG and nose of the aircraft is ahead of the CG. So they are going in this, right? So they are going in the opposite direction of that. So now, so secondary controls, as far as the secondary control surfaces are concerned, there are many secondary control surfaces like flaps, slats, spoilers, slots, not exactly the slots, but the slats is the secondary control surfaces, spoilers are secondary control surfaces. In some cases, there are even trim tabs. Trim tabs are also the secondary control surfaces. And as far as the different light vehicles are concerned, they are heavier than air are the airplanes, and lighter than air are the balloons. Fixed wing aircrafts, rotor wing aircrafts are under the category of airplanes. And as far as the balloons are concerned, airships, dirigibles are the best examples for this, for the lighter than air aircrafts. So what exactly this lighter than aircrafts are talking about is, sometimes even the lighter than airs or lighter than air aircrafts are aerostats. So that means they remain stagnant in the air. So that is known as the aerostats, right? So the aerostats nowadays, they are mostly used in the application of the communication devices at the remote location. So we will keep one dirigible at one location, and by using that dirigible and completely fixed, so that when it is completely tethered to the ground, so that is tied to the ground, so there we can utilize even as a communication satellite also. Where the communication is not possible, in that case this aeronautical engineers or the aircraft devices are utilizing there. And heavier than airplanes, as you all know, they are fixed wing aircrafts, and aeroplanes they are called generally, or in some northern American language they are called as an airplane, but generally for us we can say airplanes or aeroplanes. Both the words says that it is heavier than airplanes or heavier than aircrafts which are designed to fly in air. Now, let us see some configurations related based upon the, here we are going to deal with the aircraft configurations of different categorization. How did we make? So this is my personal variation of the classification. So how did I categorize this configuration? I have categorized based upon the wing platform. So that is based upon the wing shape. So how can I see the wing shape? So when we see from the top view of this wing, so we can see that wing platforms. So based upon the wing platforms and based upon the wing placements and based upon the tail assembly, right? So and based upon the landing gear and the number of landing gears and position of the landing gears. So that arrangement of the landing gears, based upon that also we can categorize the aircraft configurations. And next, based upon the power plant. So which type of power plant generally we are using on an aircraft? So even we can say based upon that also, this type of aircraft. I'm not talking about any company names or the brand names here in this one. I'm just talking about the general categorization as well as the geometrical view of an aircraft is concerned. As a geometrical view or the pictorial view or based upon the attachments it has on an aircraft have been categorized here in this one. So I'm not categorizing any company or any based what are the production and all that. Right, so here just we are looking at that particular one. And when we see the top of the wings, so how can we see the wing? If you are standing in front of the aircraft, we can't see this exact view of the wing. So this wing views are possible when we are looking it from the top view of it. Only when we are looking at the top view of it. Right. So as far as the front view is concerned, you will be seeing that wing as like this one. Right. As far as the front view is concerned, so you will be seeing that wing as like this only. Right. But when I see in the top view, so this is what the top platform. So this is the top platform of this. Right. So that is possible even when you're seeing that wing from the top view of it. So we can see this different wing platforms. So when it is completely rectangular and the straight wing. So rectangular straight wing. And in the second case, we have seen some here at the middle of it. So that is where that is central portion of it. And it is moving outwards of the wing. So that the wing got slightly tapered in that. And at the end, we have again aileron surfaces are available on this one. And in the rectangular straight wing, we have ailerons as well as flaps on that one. And the third case we have, it's somewhat rounded and you can say closely to the elliptical wing. But even in this one, we have a flaps located or flaps placed on this wing. You can see that flaps also on this third configuration. And in the fourth configuration, we have slightly swept wing, but on the wings, there is a movable surface. That is ailerons are available on it and moderately swept wing. So here, this swept is happening backward of the aircraft because as far as the nose of the aircraft is concerned, the swept is happening in the backward direction. It's a backward swept. And slightly swept, moderately swept, highly swept. And if you make it more than a highly swept, it will completely form a delta. When you're getting close to this one, so what is left? Then there is nothing left to make it a more swept in that one. So completely the structure has to get joined. So that will become a simple delta wing. And in delta wings also we have some complex delta wings, or people will say double delta wings. So that means two deltas are being placed in the wing platforms. That where arrangements are also possible. And the best example out of that configurations of the wing what we have seen in the previous slide. So here we can see that canard configuration. The canard configuration which states that in this canard configuration we have. So completely, it is not a backward swept wing. It is a completely forward swept wing, and we don't have that horizontal stabilizer behind. The horizontal stabilizer has got in the forward. So the horizontal stabilizer has been placed here, right? So in this zone, the horizontal stabilizer has come up. So there is missing horizontal stabilizer is not there behind the wing, and this is what the nose of the aircraft is. Nose of the aircraft is in this direction. So nose of the aircraft is in this direction, and here we have the tail wing is ahead of the main wing. So in this case, the tail wing will become, so this will be becoming our main wing, and this is our tail wing. This is our tail wing, right? So this is our tail wing. So this configuration is completely different from the regular. So this configuration, when they are not conventional, when they are not seen as a regular one, so they can even categorize as conventional and unconventional type of configurations. They can be called as a conventional and unconventional type of configuration. So here the Grumman's configuration, Grumman's X aircraft. So that means when I'm talking about the name of the aircraft. So actually the configuration is canard configuration. So this configuration or this type of configurations will be coming under the unconventional type. They are not the conventional. When I regularly assume that what an airplane is, they don't look in the similar part. So these configurations are called unconventional type of configurations. Okay, so this is the difference between the conventional and the unconventional types. Okay, so in this one, the stabilizer has been placed. So now let us see based upon the wing placement. So here in this one, so where in this slide, we are looking at the aircraft in front of that. So we are just standing in front of the aircraft and we are looking at its front view of it. We are looking the front view of the aircraft. When I'm looking at the front view of the aircraft here in this first image, I can see where it is named as a high wing configuration. The wing is the wing mounting. So that is here we are, our interest is based upon the wing mount, not based upon the wing attachment, where the wing is attached to it. So here in this first configuration, when we see, so the wing is completely above the fuselage location. The wing is completely above the fuselage that is being placed. So this type of configuration is called high wing type configuration. This is called, that means based upon the wing mount, we are calling it here. And in the second type of configuration, when you see, compared to the fuselage, as far as the fuselage is concerned, it is neither upper, it is neither bottom of the fuselage, but it is exactly mid of the wing. So that it is called as a mid-wing configuration. So the wing is exactly mid of the fuselage it is being attached. So that is mid-wing configuration. And here in the third case, we see that the aircraft fuselage, to the fuselage, the wing is attached bottom of that one. So that type of configuration. So that is, the wing is mounted to the bottom of the fuselage. This type of configurations are called low-wing configurations. These are all called low-wing configurations. So high-wing, based upon the fuselage. So in all the three cases, my reference is fuselage, or our reference is fuselage. Based upon the fuselage only, we are talking about this one. So with respect to the fuselage, that is top. With respect to the fuselage, this is middle. With respect to the fuselage, this is bottom. Right. So low wing, mid wing, and high wing configurations. Right. Based upon the wing mounting location, or based upon the wing attachment location. So now, in addition to this one, we are seeing another one in this slide or in this image, right? Or in this view, there is one more aircraft which is being placed separated from all this. What exactly this aircraft is talking about is, this is in a biplane airplane. This is in a bi-wing. So that is, there is more than one wing it is available in this one. So that wing is called biplane wing. Biplane wing. So where two wings are available on this one. So one it is at the lower side, and another one is on the upper side. So there is a low wing configuration and even the high wing attachments on this particular one. But this was the first one which was used by the Wright brothers, which is called as a biplane configuration. Okay, so that is all about, based upon the wing placements. Based upon the wing placements, we are categorizing the type of the configuration we are calling it. So here, on the image or on screen, we can see different types of configurations. Here we can see the different types of aircraft wing mountings in that one. So different arrangements are being made in this one. So now next, let us see based upon the tail assembly. There are many configurations according to the tail assembly. These are all just to identify for you. These are all just for identification, right? These configurations are required. So let us go with the first conventional one or the standard one. So here we can see where the conventional or the standard one is. Generally, we will be seeing this type of configurations. So this is called as a standard tail configuration. And when we are talking about the horizontal stabilizer and vertical stabilizer in combination, that complete one will be called as empennage. When a horizontal stabilizer and vertical stabilizer is in combination, we are dealing with, that is called as the empennages. So here we are dealing with the different types of empennage configurations. And in standard configurations, in standard one, we see this vertical stabilizer with a rudder and a horizontal stabilizer with the elevators. This is what generally we see in the standard configuration. But this is what the conventional type of configuration. Other than this standard configuration, remaining all configurations are called as unconventional type. Okay. Now here in this one you can see. So on the top one. So when it is called as a dorsal fin. So that is dorsal fin is the one. So where I have got, see here if you see in this one, let me annotate it and show you for your better understanding. So here there is a smooth curvature it is given on this one, on the wing to the fuselage attachment. But here in this one, if you see, straightly it is ended. So suddenly we have ended with this one. So when you are making a smooth curvature like this one, like this, to attach out to the wing assembly, or wing that is vertical stabilizer assembly to the fuselage assembly, then it is called as a dorsal fin. And when you have extended surfaces below the fuselage, other than the horizontal stabilizer I'm talking about, other than the horizontal stabilizer, when you have extended portions out from the fuselage section, that is downwards of the fuselage section, then it is called as a ventral fuse. Then they are called as a ventral fuse. So based upon the tail assembly, this type of configurations are called dorsal fins and the ventral fins. And next, in this case, let us focus on this twin tail configuration. So in the twin tail configuration, we have two wings or two vertical stabilizers. One end where again horizontal stabilizer, it is not the vertical stabilizer is centrally mounted on it. We have one end, so that means horizontal stabilizer tip, we have one vertical stabilizer and another one we have at this one. So this type of configuration, we'll call it as twin tail configuration. This type of configuration we'll call it as a twin tail configuration. And if you are looking it from the behind, of the wing, so if your configuration, so if that vertical stabilizer are extended downwards, the vertical stabilizers are extended downwards, then it can also be called as H type of configuration. Then it can be called even as a H type of configuration. So this is our horizontal stabilizer. These two are the vertical stabilizers, right? In this type of configurations will be called as twin tail configurations or H tail configuration. They are called as a twin tail or H tail configurations. Okay, let us see some more here in this one. Now, so when we are talking about this T tail configuration, so when I'm seeing from the front of the aircraft, here you see the horizontal stabilizer has been shifted at the tip of the vertical stabilizer. Then this type of configurations are called twin tail configuration. So this type of configurations are called as a twin tail configuration. This is called as a twin tail configuration. Okay, so that is called as a T tail configuration, where we are seeing it as a T type. So that means horizontal stabilizer is being shifted onto the vertical stabilizer. That type of empennages are called T tail configuration. And here you can see the other type of configuration is that you have butterfly type of configuration, where the vertical stabilizer is missing in this case. In the V type configuration, that is V butterfly tail configuration, the vertical stabilizer is missing in this one. So that it is called as a butterfly tail configuration. Let us quickly move on to the next type of configuration even. So that is based upon the tail assembly, based upon the empennage assembly. Here you can see, so we can even call it as, here we can call it as fuselage mounted, that is the conventional type of configuration. And see here in this case, here it is neither T type of configuration, neither the conventional type of configuration, where the horizontal stabilizer is exactly middle of the vertical stabilizer. Then that type of configurations we will call it as cruciform configuration. Then that type of configuration is called as a cruciform type of configuration. And this is a T-tail configuration, just now we have seen that. And here in this type of configuration, we have flying tail plane configuration. So that means the tail plane is adjusting according to this. The tail plane is adjusting according to the aircraft requirement. So that is based upon the CG requirements. So the tail plane, if it is being adjusting, so completely movable tail plane, then it is called flying tail plane configuration. So this is tail plane mounted that we have discussed. It has a twin tail configuration. And this is called as a twin boom. So where you see the vertical stabilizers are being attached, to the main wing to the tail wing. So they are attached from the main wing to the tail wing. So this type of configuration is called as a twin boom configuration, right? And if there is no horizontal stabilizer at all, then it is called as a wing mounted vertical stabilizer. Then they are called as a wing mounted vertical stabilizer. And when you have more than one vertical stabilizer, like this one, it is mounted regular configuration of vertical stabilizer, but two vertical stabilizers are available on the horizontal stabilizer, but at the end, that is tips of it, then it is called as a triple fins configuration. And as we have discussed here, ventral fin configuration, so that when the fuselage below side, if the vertical stabilizer are being extended or they are placed at an angle, then they are called ventral fin configuration. So even that the butterfly configuration can also be called as a V-tail configuration. And if your V-tail is inverted, so then it is called inverted V-tail configuration. And in some of the aircrafts, very rarely we see this type of X-tail configuration, but the X-tail configuration is used not in the airplanes, but they are best utilized in the missiles. The X-tail configuration, they are best utilized in the missile configuration. These are all about based upon the tail assembly. Based upon the tail assembly, we have discussed about how do we categorize that particular tail assembly on that aircraft, on the aircraft. So let us quickly move on to this one, next one. So let us talk about what the first one is saying about this, and the second type, that is, and third, fourth and fifth type of configurations, where we can see in this the different types of configurations are being presented and animated here in this one. So you can see that different configurations are already addressed in this. Okay. So here in this animation, we can see the first one, which is showing the T-tail configuration, and second, it is the butterfly or the V-tail configuration, and third one, it is cruciform configuration, and fourth one, it is a H-tail configuration, and this is the twin tail, so that is the twin stabilizer configuration, and this is the twin boom configuration. So there are six configurations are being shown and represented by animations here in this image. Now let's move on to the, when we are moving on to this particular one, so that is based upon the landing gear arrangements. Based upon the landing gear arrangement, so if the aircraft is having 1, 2, and 3 gears when we are landing, so when we are calling, the wheels of the aircraft will be called as the landing gears, and here we have one wheel on the nose and two wheels at the mid of the aircraft. And if you see, their arrangement is somewhat like this, that is wheel 1, wheel 2 and wheel 3. So two wheels on the main body and one wheel at the nose wheel configuration. So this will be called as a nose wheel, and this will be called as a mid wheels. And this type of triangular formation will be called as triangular or tricycle landing gear configuration. Tricycle landing gear configuration. And when we have two landing gears available on the underneath of the wing, so equally distributed on both the wings, and one tail wheel, so we don't have the nose wheel here in this case in the second configuration, but where the landing gear is available at the tail location, that is called tail wheel or tail dragger configuration. And some configurations will be like, there is only nose wheels, and there is no tail wheel, or there is no the mid wheel. So then it is called as a skid type of landing gears. Then that